this video, we will look at ways to analyze track data in Kinetica. To refresh our memories, track data is a geospatial data object used in Kinetica to represent the paths of objects in space and time. Each track requires a track ID, X and Y coordinates, and a timestamp. We can perform analytical operations on track data using endpoints that use Kinetica's REST API. The first track operation that we will look at uses the filter by area endpoint. Given an input polygon and track data, this endpoint creates a stencil view where the tracks that are either contained by the polygon or intersect with it are filtered. This is useful for identifying all the tracks that have passed through a region of interest. Now you might wonder how this is different from filtering non-track data based on a spatial relationship. The key difference here is that if we overlaid the points without the timestamp, there might be cases where the points don't intersect with the input polygon. However, since we are dealing with a special data type that uses timestamps to sequentially arrange the data and then interpolate between them, we are able to then apply that interpolated track to filter by area. The next endpoint that can be used is filter by box. This is the same as filter by area, except that it works on a provided rectangular region. The thing to note about both filter by area and by box is that once the tracks are filtered, the resulting view only contains data for the portion of the track that is inside those areas. But in several use cases, we would like to have the data for the entirety of the track and not just the portion inside that area. This is where we can use the getRecordsBySeries endpoint, which takes a filtered view as its input and retrieves the entire set of associated data for that track from the original track table. Say we have a filtered view as shown here. When this is passed to the endpoint along with the table that contains all the track data, it'll return all the track data that is associated with the filtered set of track IDs. A common use case for this would be to return data on a track based on a user interaction on a map, like say clicking on a particular track on a dashboard app. Note that getRecordsBySeries endpoint only returns the data. It does not update the view itself. If we want to update the view with the entirety of the track data, then we can use the updateRecordsBySeries endpoint. This endpoint, instead of retrieving the associated track data, will update the view itself. That brings us to the end. Let's wrap up with a quick summary. In this video, we covered how we can filter track data that are within a particular area using the filter by area and by box endpoints. And then we learned how to use the getRecordsBySeries and the updateRecordsBySeries endpoints to either return the entire track data for the tracks in a filtered view or update that view table with it.